Can you explain the primitive data types in Java?
In Java, primitive data types are basic building blocks for representing simple values like numbers and characters. There are 8 primitive data types in Java. Byte, used to store small integers. Short, similar to byte, used for short integers. Int, stores whole numbers. Long, for larger whole numbers. Float, represents single precision floating point numbers. Double, represents double precision floating point numbers. Char, stores single characters. Boolean, represents true or false values.
Explain the differences between int and integer.
Int is a primitive data type, while integer is a wrapper class for the int primitive type. This means that int is a basic data type that stores an actual numerical value, while integer is an object that wraps around an int value and provides additional methods and functionalities.
What is the default value of all primitive data types in Java?
The default values for primitive data types in Java are byte, short, int, long, 0. Float, double, 0.0. Char, / U0000, null character. Boolean, false.
Why use a primitive data type like int instead of an object type like integer?
Using primitive data types like int is generally more memory efficient and faster in terms of performance compared to using their corresponding wrapper classes like integer. Primitives are stored directly in memory, while wrapper classes introduce additional overhead due to object creation and management.
Explain the concept of a floating point data type in Java.
Certainly. Floating point data types, float and double, are used to represent numbers with decimal points or fractional parts. They allow for a wider range of values but may have slight accuracy limitations due to the way they're stored in memory.
What is the difference between the float and double data types in Java?
The main difference is in their precision. Float is a single precision floating point type that occupies 32 bits and can represent a smaller range of values with lower precision. On the other hand, double is a double precision floating point type that occupies 64 bits, providing a larger range and higher precision.
Explain the concept of type casting or type conversion.
Type casting, also known as type conversion, is the process of converting a value from one data type to another. It can be either implicit, widening, or explicit, narrowing. Implicit type casting occurs when the destination type can safely hold all possible values of the source type. Explicit type casting is required when the conversion might result in loss of data, and it needs to be performed manually using casting operators.
What is autoboxing and unboxing in Java?
Autoboxing is the automatic conversion that Java performs between primitive types and their corresponding wrapper classes. For example, converting an int to an integer. Unboxing, on the other hand, is the automatic conversion of a wrapper class back to its primitive type. Java handles these conversions behind the scenes to make code more convenient to read and write.
Explain the concept of widening, implicit, and narrowing, explicit, conversions.
Widening, or implicit, conversion happens when you're converting from a data type with smaller storage size to a data type with larger storage size. Java can perform this conversion automatically because no data loss occurs. Narrowing, or explicit, conversion is the opposite. It involves converting from a larger data type to a smaller one, which may result in data loss. This requires manual type casting to indicate that you're aware of the potential loss.
What is the purpose of the string data type in Java?
The string data type in Java is used to represent sequences of characters. It's one of the most commonly used classes and is essential for working with text and manipulating strings. Strings in Java are immutable, meaning their values cannot be changed after they're created.
What is the default value of the Boolean data type in Java?
The default value of the Boolean data type in Java is false.
Can you explain what operators are in Java?
Certainly. In Java, operators are symbols used to perform operations on variables and values. They manipulate data and produce results.
Differentiate between unary, binary, and ternary operators.
Unary operators work on a single operand, like the increment or negation operator. Binary operators work on two operands, like addition or comparison. Ternary operators, like the conditional operator, involve three operands and allow for conditional assignments.
Explain the difference between the equals equals operator and the equals method for comparing objects.
The equals equals operator checks if two object references point to the same memory location. The equals method, if properly overwritten, compares the content of objects for equality. It's used for meaningful comparison, often used with strings and other complex objects.
Explain the difference between the pre-increment and post-increment operators.
Pre-increment, +x, increments the value of x and then returns the updated value. Post-increment, x++, returns the current value of x and then increments it. For example, int x equals 5, int y equals +x, makes y equal to 6, whereas int x equals 5, int y equals x++, makes y equal to 5.
What is operator precedence in Java?
Operator precedence determines the order in which operators are evaluated. Operators with higher precedence are evaluated before those with lower precedence. For instance, multiplication takes precedence over addition.
What is the difference between the and operators?
Both are logical and operators, but there's a difference. And evaluates both operands even if the first is false, while and uses short-circuiting. If the first operand is false, the second is not evaluated.
What is the use of the instanceof operator in Java?
The instanceof operator checks whether an object is an instance of a particular class or interface. It's commonly used to determine if an object can be safely typecast to another type.
What is the difference between equals equals and equals for comparing strings?
Equals equals checks if string references point to the same memory location, while equals checks if the content of the strings is the same. For meaningful content comparison, equals is generally used.